the NBA playoffs on TNT. Brought to you by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By Ford, makers of vehicles that are built to last. By Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Life is a hunger for victory, a hunger to play. It doesn't have to be a question of thirst. Life is a sport. Drink it up. And by Nike.
Well, they're still partying here in Salt Lake City over their Utah Jazz, but it's a little more subdued coming into this game because this one is serious business for Utah if the first one wasn't. The Houston Rockets started with that lineup of Maloney, Drexler, Willis, Olajuwon, and Bullard. Starting Bullard so he can play Adam Keefe, and it frees up Mario Elie to come off the bench to play against the faster second unit of Utah, which is a significant factor in game one. We thought, or I thought, Reggie, there was going to be perhaps a change in the lineup here, but we'll have you talk about this in a moment. But they're staying with that starting lineup with Foster and Keefe up front. Let's go now to D-Lineup.
With containing the legs number 32 and number 12 and ignoring section 8. It was this group of Jazz fans that assisted Charles Barkley in making his recent $10,000 donation to the NBA. In game one, section 8 delivered only jeers to number 4. I think they might actually hear a few cheers tonight. Bob?
Thanks, D. World War II veterans will appreciate section 8. Speaking of section 8.
Ground zero over there.
Go Jazz, that's the man. He is, he said he was on local television, the Jazz man there. He's a local ticket broker, by the way, and a big, obviously, fan. He said, I never used profanity with Charles. Charles got in my face, and I simply said, from one ball guy to another, you're too old, you should retire. That would make Charlie.
And listen, sometimes if they're going to fine the players for doing things, I think they have to make an adjustment with fans in the arenas that cause players problems also, right, even though they're paying money for their tickets.
Yeah, that's a good point, Reggie. There's two sides to it, and there's a great deal more security around that area here tonight. The officials tonight, Hugh Evans, Ronnie Nunn, and Ken Maurer, we're ready to get underway. Utah, all of a sudden, find themselves in a bind. They're down 0-1. Houston's aging veteran showed the heart of a champion and stole game one two nights ago.
So much of this game start is about the energy level. And of course, John Stockton getting off to a good start is a great thing for the Utah Jazz.
John Stockton scored 12 points in game number one. Had 8 assists, but certainly didn't get that pick and roll working as well as they had hoped. And an early whistle by Hugh Evans, and that foul is going to be off Greg Foster. And Reggie, we mentioned about that we thought Utah might change their starting lineup, but Jerry Sloan, no.
And listen, Jerry Sloan couldn't fix with lineup start what happened to Utah. It was all about energy and doing the right thing in the middle defensively.
Well, defensively this time, Utah playing so tough, they're called for their first illegal defense of this ball game. Utah out to a 2-0 lead. We're in the first minute of the first quarter. Hope you enjoyed on TNT earlier tonight that Charlotte-Atlanta game. Charlotte takes a 2-0 lead in that series. Houston is 17 on the shot clock. Going into the post, coming back out. They went in for Willis, and now Malone, who's so adept at it, strips the ball loose. 11 on the shot clock for Houston.
And Bob, you can see that the Jazz defense is really waiting to bounce down on those low post guys.
Bullard's jump shot on the inbound pass, rebound Drexler. Rebounding was a big key. Drexler from the perimeter, that's a triple for Clyde Drexler. 3-2, Houston. Karl Malone off to a very slow start in game one, but he did finish the game with 25 points and 11 boards. Stockton driving and kicking. Foster open for the jumper from 18. Those were the open shots Foster and others missed on the penetration by Utah in game one. Maloney looking down to Olajuwon against Foster. Team. Bullard, excellent three-point shooter. Houston starting much like they started in game number one. Two triples already in the first minute and a half.
Well, because of the potential double teams, there's always a lot of spot-up shots, and these guys are very good, Bullard and Maloney, hitting the spot-up jumpers.
Stockton gets a big pick from Adam Keefe, leaving him alone for the jumper. Olajuwon with a rebound. Olajuwon had 16 and 13 in game number one, along with 6 blocks and 5 assists. Hosting Willis. He's got this jumper here he likes to take if Malone gives him any room. He didn't, so Willis drives. It's stripped. different looking Karl Malone earlier.
And you can't tell me, you can't tell there's a difference in the energy level of the Utah Jazz tonight starting this basketball game.
Houston was aware of it, as Charles Barkley said. We know how they're going to come out here. We've got to play with that same intensity. Stopped and slipped inside, but the defense recovered in time to get the block and the turnover. Maloney driving, dishing. Willis. Stockton runs down the tip. 6-4 Rockets ahead. Hornacek in the paint, dishing to Adam Keefe. Can't handle it. Saved it though. Karl Malone missing. Rebounding Houston.
Again, Houston Rockets doing a great job in their own transition defense. Both teams running the floor, getting back.
Drexler misses the three. We've got a loose ball foul. It's going to be on Kevin Willis.
Oh yeah, we're seeing a different Utah Jazz energy level tonight starting off this basketball game. And as we talked about in the open, Karl Malone sets that pace already. A couple of steals, putting his body on people and getting after the rebound.
Early shooting, both 2 of 5. The difference is the 2 for Houston are triples. Malone left alone for the jumper. He missed again. Stockton down hard. It's going to be against Houston. And already, look at this, Stockton and Maloney. Now Foster stepping in. The officials, a referee crew tonight, who are veterans, Hugh Evans, Ronnie Nunn, Ken Maurer, calm it down before anything breaks out.
And Bob, when you look at this, there wasn't that much for Stockton. I think a little bit of a flop is in there. But certainly Malone and Stockton getting out, setting the tempo. All of a sudden Stockton is standing up to a 6'10" guy saying, get out my face.
That foul was on Maloney. Big pick from Malone. Stockton losing the handle. 13 on the shot clock for John. Pull up jumper. Now he's going to bury those from the elbow at 16, 17 feet.
Olajuwon has to step up and get in John's face, make him turn the corner.
Maloney's penetration to Olajuwon. 8-6 Rockets. 8:21 to go. First period. Game 2. Houston with a 1-0 lead, surprising everybody in the NBA. The way they came out and dominated the game in nearly every phase on Thursday night.
Utah Jazz running an awful lot early in this game. The UCLA cut. They're trying to free up their big men, getting down in the post areas. John Stockton runs that UCLA cut as good as anyone in the league.
Ronnie Nunn with a call this time, and it's going to be on Clyde Drexler. Officiating, and the foul calls are substantially increased in this game. Karl Malone shot only 5 free throw attempts in the entire game, had none in the first half in game number 1. The whistle sounding more often, more frequently here in this first quarter. Stockton to Foster. Foster, who was missing from the perimeter in game 1, has 2 jump shots and is 2 for 2 here in this game. It's tied at 8. Maloney doesn't get the 3. Malone rebounding. Foster's alone again for that mid-range jumper. Not this time.
In the same spot, Foster could put it down, but John Stockton is really aggressive offensively, and that's going to cause a lot of problems for Houston defensively.
4 shots already for Stockton. Olajuwon now with 4 points, and it's 10-8 Rockets.
Because, Bob, anytime Stockton is really aggressive, he's going to cause problems in the middle, and he's going to be looking to kick out to the open shooters.
Drexler on Hornacek. Another foul in the paint, holding on to Stockton. This is going to be on Hakeem Olajuwon, flirting with a technical. Crowd on their feet. Hold it. A technical on Rudy Tomjanovich. The foul was on Maloney, his 2nd. And a technical on Rudy T. 14 fouls already for Houston.
Ronnie Nunn and Hugh Evans quickly in this game, Bob, taking control, stopping the and cleaning up the action underneath the basket and not allowing the coach to really get up and say anything. We're only 4 minutes into the first quarter.
Let's take a look at it again. Watch Matt Maloney, number 12, in the paint.
Matt Maloney in the paint right there, getting after it. Pushing right after the play, and they had locked up, gave that little bit of an extra push, and that's what the referee called.
Maloney goes to the bench. Brent Price, who had 4 threes and 2 assists in his first ever NBA playoff game, and now he's defending John Stockton. Hornacek off the screen, gets inside Drexler from 18, and that's the fourth lead change of this ball game. 11-10 Jazz. Elijah Wan defended by Foster. Shake and bake move inside. The dream shake, as they like to call it. Nothing coming out of it that time, though. Shot clock. Malone's turnaround. That's his bread and butter. So I guess he had the bread and no butter. Price driving. Offensive foul.
Oh, that's great footwork by a big man, Karl Malone. Price giving a little bit of a shake, but Malone, watch his footwork down here low. Check him out. Slide, slide, take the contact, and slide back. Nice play.
Three Houston turnovers early.
Come on, let's go faster, faster.
He's really driving us. He's killing us.
I'm pulling away from you.
It helps, though. I don't think I could do it on my own.
I know. This is the longest I've ever stuck with a workout program.
Well, they say motivation is the key.
You can do it. Come on, you bunch of lost brothers. I don't see any sweat.
No wonder you can never get a bike around here.
This is what you're working for.
It is the mind that makes the muscles move. But it is the skin that speaks to the mind when it is cold, or wet, or chafed, or exposed, or overheated. And the mind must do whatever the skin tells it. Nike Fit Performance Apparel. The evolution of skin.
Sunday at a Superstation premiere. They had it all until he moved in.
He's evil.
What are you making me do here?
Melanie Griffith and Michael Keaton, Pacific Heights, 9 Eastern, Sunday night, only on the Superstation.
We got next.
Stockton's active early, 4 points, three assists.
And Bob, when he's active, this is what happens. Look at this freezer, guys. Look at, he draws three guys to the middle, and John Stockton always able to kick it out to open people. Foster finding the thread.
Karl Malone yet to score. He's 0 for 3. The rest of the Jazz team, however, 5 out of 8 early on. Foster driving. He has 6. 13 to 10 Jazz. I told you there have been 4 lead changes. There are only 2 lead changes in the entire game in game number 1.
Tough change of direction. Clyde Drexler really got caught from a good defensive play, but when he put it behind his back, the defense was totally stunned and had to do what they did and just foul.
That's the second team foul. It was on Adam Keefe. Second team foul on Utah. The next Houston foul, as Drexler hits the jumper, the next Houston foul will put the Jazz at the line. Brent Price defending Stockton. Bullard on Adam Keefe. Stockton got open and thanks to a pick by Foster.
Oh.
Fouled before the shot, but that is team foul number 5. It's called on Brent Price, and Stockton will go to the free throw line where he is an 83% shooter.
Well, I'll tell you something that's happened tonight that didn't happen in game 1. Right there, you see a little contact, and I'm telling you, Utah Jazz are setting some serious picks tonight, and that is getting guys open right there. Price was banged and still hadn't recovered from the pick that was set on him a couple steps earlier.
And Utah, of course, is noted for the powerful picks they sent, not just their big guys either. However, you commented you only saw a couple of those in game one.
And Bob, that is what gets this team going. Jerry Sloan said it. Execution, picks, and tough defense. That's what gets them into their element of playing the great basketball.
Well, the Rockets aren't going anywhere. It's 14-12, and that reverse on the assist to Drexler by Brent Price ties it at 14.
Just a great, one of the best plays in basketball. Simple, give and go. I give it to you, you give it back.
Yet another Houston foul down on the baseline as they were trying to free up a player on the baseline for John Stockton, who will go to the bench here at the five-minute mark. And we'll get Howard Eisley into the game. Also, Mario Elie has entered the game. Drexel is flirting with a technical right now.
Well, he's really upset about the bodies and the beat that's being thrown around. In the first game, there was a lot of that going Houston's way. Look at the bench production.
Hold it, there's a technical. It's going to be on Clyde Drexler. We knew that was coming. Ronnie Nunn was the man who was involved in the discussion.
Not a bad thing. Technical being thrown on Clyde because he's got to let the refs know what's going on down on the baseline. There's a lot of blows and a lot of picks being set hard down in the, underneath the basket.
Talking to Ken Maurer. Backing away now. The free throw being shot, it's good by Hornacek.
It's not a bad thing, Bob, for a veteran guy like Clyde Drexler to let the referees know early in the game what's going on.
Yeah, there are two fouls each on Price and Maloney, and now two on Drexler. 15-14 Jazz. This is also a very different tenor to the game. Very few fouls. I think it was Houston 5 out of 6. And Utah 3 out of 4 from the free throw line in the entire first half.
Well, that's because we only had one aggressive team in game one, and that was the Houston Rockets.
Well, they haven't lost their aggression, that's for sure. Malone hits the free throw. Check this throw.
Yeah.
10 points, only 3 rebounds in the first half of game one. He did come back strong with 15 and 8 in the second half, but it was definitely too little too late.
Well, the man averages 10 attempts during the regular season and only got 5 in game one.
Jazz by a couple of points. 5 or 7 to go, first period. Mario Elie, Eddie Johnson, down to Olajuwon, posted deep. He's going to score. You have to foul him down there once he gets that kind of entry pass. Olajuwon was kind of quiet in the early going of the ball game, also in game number one, but he turned out to have a whale of a night with 6 blocks, 5 assists, 16 points, and 13 rebounds.
Total team effort by the Houston Rockets. Willis starting the action off early with his effort. Olajuwon, 5 blocks in the second half. 5 assists also to go along with that, and then Charles Barkley adding his action in the second half really sustained that, because you have to remember in the 4 games during the regular season, Bob, they were up in the fourth quarter in those games and fell in the end.
Barkley, by the way, who came in and was very productive in the second half, said he's feeling really good. He was out playing one-on-one before the game. He'll be in shortly. Brian Russell goes to the hoop hard and draws yet another Houston foul. This time it's going to be on Eddie Johnson. Eddie Johnson, when questioned, he's 39 years old, questioned whether this will be his last year. He says, hey, I take 1 year at a time at my age.
Listen, as long as he can hit a jumper behind the three, he's not going nowhere.
Eddie Johnson in his 16th year. Remember his great years at the University of Illinois. Brian Russell started the season very poorly, started as a starter, couldn't play very well, didn't do a lot of things, asked to go to the bench, and he's now part of his second unit that has become so very effective for Utah. Eisley, Shandon Anderson, and Russell. Eisley and Russell on the floor. Anderson not yet in. Here's the three. Price. Not this time. Tip. Nice play by Eddie Johnson. Loose ball picked up, however, by the Utah Jazz, Jeff Hornacek.
Look at the aggressive hands of Utah tonight. Unbelievable. That's the third rake they've had without a foul being called.
Moments before Barkley enters the game, you hear the boos already as he takes off his warm-up. 7 on the shot clock for Utah.
They're not doing anything to get him fired up by doing that.
Eisley from 18. Rebound Willis. Third rebound of this ball game for Kevin Willis. Kevin had 14 in game number one. From the corner, Elie misses. Willis rebounds. Houston out rebounding Utah 11-4 early on. That was one of the keys to the Houston win early. It's tied at 17. Malone. First field goal of the night with 3:40 to go in period number one. Timeout Houston.
First field goal, but definitely a better effort offensively and defensively just with energy level alone.
2-point lead, Jazz 19, Rockets 17, and here's Carl's first, let's call that a 17-footer.
These guys, Ray and Charlie, they're always betting each other.
So you believe me or not?
No. So Ray bets Charlie he can pull an 8,000-ton ship.
You got a bet.
With a pickup. What Charlie didn't bet on was Ray's pickup, the tough new Ford Super Duty F-Series with the most powerful diesel engine of any pickup on Earth.
Wonder what old Charlie had to do for losing that bet.
Word to the wise, never bet against an F-Series. It's built Ford tough.
Need a start?
Boyer's got it.
Need a lift?
Galen Boyer's got it.
And right now, every truck on the lot is discounted for spring cleaning. This week, get a 98 Sierra for as low as $22,895, or get up to $1,500 cash back on a Sonoma. Drive home a Jimmy with $1,000 cash back, or get 4.9% financing for 48 months. GMCs are now on sale during spring cleaning at Galen Boyer. Galen Boyer on the Miracle Mile, Nolan Road, Independence.
Your friends at Jones Intercable feel it is our duty to give something back to the community that we service. In 1997, Jones Intercable contributed over $50,000 to the local charities and community events that you see listed on your screen. This list represents just a sampling of the programs that we assist throughout the year. It is our privilege to provide our valued customers with state-of-the-art cable service, as well as assist these many worthwhile causes. Thank you for your continued patronage, which makes all of this possible.
The fans cursed me. I'm going to curse them back. Plain and simple, not even worth discussing. If a person cursed me, I'm going to curse them back. NBA can have all my money, but I'm not going to let anybody take my pride. If somebody curses me, I'm going to curse them back.
Well, that's simple. You see the fans there. Is it Barkley or Broccoli? Who cares? They both stink. Charles usually thrives in terms of his game on that kind of thing. The NBA took $10,000 of his money. You see what he got, though, in game one. 12 points, 6 out of 10. And post-game, he came out here in front of the Utah fans after they had won, practice free throw, and took laps.
Well, he told me after the game also that those are things that he has to do. He needs it. He's feeling good. And you're right, Bob. Those are the things, fans, signs, all the interaction, that gets him fired up and turned on about basketball. Great players are always looking for a way to get the edge.
Worth the price of admission. 14 seconds on the shot clock for Houston. Trailing by 2. Barkley. Offensive foul as he pushed Karl Malone out of the way.
These two guys have always done that to each other. I've seen it go both ways. Right here, Karl's bodying hard and giving. Now, Charles says, get off me, give him a nudge, and you know the referee is looking at that.
Now Malone at Barkley. Barkley steals the ball. This could be a great battle between two of the best power forwards in the history of the game.
And both of them, great hands in raking balls away from each other.
Ostertag also in. Barkley shoots it over the 7-2 Ostertag. Too high, too much. Rebound Malone. Ostertag, Isley, Hornacek, Russell, Malone on the floor for the Utah Jazz, leading by 2, 2:55 to go in the first period. Game 2, Western Conference playoffs. Houston stole game 1 here at the Delta Center. Well, Isley, clock to 6.
Isley coming in this game has to have a big night. It gives them a great depth and another look. Last night, only 2 points when he averages about 7 a game.
Willis open for that jumper. Not as hot as he was in the first half, where he had 17 points. In game one, Malone on the break from Hornacek.
That is a great look by Jeff Hornacek. Not even, Karl Malone didn't even have to know it was coming. Jeff just lobbed it up there softly and let Karl run under. Great play.
This is the biggest lead now, Jazz by 4. Biggest lead for either team. 2:12 to go first period. Willis yet to get off in this game here tonight. Here's that open 3, Brent Price. Not tonight, he had 4 in game 1. Gonna be a foul on Houston. Ken Maurer with the whistle. If there's such a thing, that could have been a good one, though. It would have been a breakaway.
Karl Malone doing a great job starting this thing off. But watch Jeff's eyes. He's just barely looking at Carl. Charles Barkley never turned his head, never knew it was coming until it was too late.
That's the 10th foul called on Houston in this first period. There have only been three whistles against the Utah Jazz with 2:02 remaining in quarter number one.
Now remember, Bob, in game one, Utah didn't get their first fast break basket until almost the end of the second quarter.
Total numbers there were 19-5 in fast break points for that whole ball game in favor of Houston. Utah's free throw numbers are worse than they were early going here in game. They shot 63%. Remember, they led the league in free throw shooting at 77. Here, they are 5 out of 10, 50% in this first quarter.
Wow. It changed things dramatically.
Barkley singled out against Malone. Going to work on it down there. Over Malone. Rebound, Greg Ostertag. 4-point Jazz lead, minute 45 to go in the period.
Early in this game,
Hornacek unmolested to the hoop. Beat Ellie off the dribble. No help was coming. Timeout, Houston.
Great effort by Jeff Hornacek. Houston Rockets playing a lot of one-on-one basketball. Bob, not what they started off in game one.
Utah on a 6-0 run. They have built the biggest lead by either team in this first period. 23-17 with a minute 39 to go in period number one. Rockets scored 27 points in the first quarter on Thursday night. And Utah 24 to give you a comparison. Here's Hornacek.
Really nice crossover and nobody in the back line. Kevin Willis just doing the MP directing traffic to the basket.
Playoffs continue tomorrow on Turner Sports. Tune in tomorrow to TNT at 8:30 p.m. for the NBA pregame show, playoff pregame show, followed by game 2 of the Wolves and Sonics at 9 Eastern time. And inside the NBA, following all our broadcasts during our plethora of playoff performances.
Utah on a 6-0 run in the last 2 minutes. Certainly a different atmosphere tonight in this game. Crowd is into the game, and so are the Jazz.
Houston's bench scored 41 points in game one, only 1-for-6 here tonight. Ellie on the drive. That's an offensive foul. Now, wait a minute. Jerry Sloan went wacky, and they're going to change the call. Hugh Evans overruled the call by Ronnie Nunn. It has to do with that dotted line circle, and the foul is going to be against Utah.
And a very good call because Ronnie Nunn was on the far side. Evans was on the strong side. Right there, you see that Hornacek was still moving as the contact occurred.
I think he may have been inside that dotted line, too. Whatever the case is, the foul's on Hornacek, and Ellie will shoot the free throw. Mario Elliott, 83% free throw shooter.
Now, I think, Bob, in the big scheme of things, only on a fast break where there's a guy trying to take a charge, I think that dotted line comes into play. If there's a blocking foul, it can go all the way under the basket.
Good point. Mario Elliott gets them both. That's only the third and fourth free throws by Houston. There have been 10 free throws by Utah in this first period. It's a 4-point Jazz lead. Hornacek on the drive. Ostertag got the miss. Then stripped out of his hands, and here comes Charles Barkley. Wanting it. You could see it all the way. Not getting it, however. Hornacek.
Houston Rockets playing well, Bob, but I don't see nearly the ball movement that they had in game one.
And they're missing a lot of good open looks at the basket. Malone tried to make the pass inside. There's going to be yet another Houston personal foul.
Bob, in game one, they had open looks in many occasions and passed it to the next guy. That gets everybody into the continuity of the offense right now, playing a little bit too much one-on-one basketball.
Mario Elliott picked up his second personal foul. Wisely goes to the free throw line. Under a minute to go, first quarter. 24-19 Jazz. Antoine Carr into the lineup. Carr Malone will sit down these final 59.1 seconds of period number one. Stockton also on the bench. Heisley's numbers in game one, a big disappointment because he has had a great year as backup point guard. Houston, five straight missed field goals. Credit a lot of Utah defense to that. But they've had some good open looks, too.
Very good open looks.
Harris. Loose ball. Utah comes away with it. That's intense swarming defense. Hornacek. That brought them to their feet. Ronnie Nunn stopping play. 27-19.
Howard Eisen finding the open man. Jeff feeling good tonight, driving to the bucket and then opening his game up from long range.
Fast break points. How about this? Utah 7, Houston none.
Flip-flop.
It was 13-2 toward the end of the first half.
Absolutely.
Game number one. 16. That'll be a new 24-second shot clock. 26 to go in the quarter. 24 on the shot clock. 27-19 Jazz. Eddie Johnson hasn't gotten a look at the basket yet. See if he gets one here in this final possession.
And the Houston Rockets, because of their one-on-one basketball and taking a lot of long shots, they're 7-for-18, shooting 39% in this first quarter.
Price off the pick set by Barkley. Kick to Bullard, stolen by Eisley, foul on Bullard. Different Jazz team.
And that is one of the reasons why Jerry Sloan didn't make any lineup changes, because the one thing that he couldn't correct with a lineup change was their effort starting in the ball game. Probably a good stern talking to in the way Jerry knows how to talk to his players in the locker room changed all that. He's a great psychologist and really one of the best in the business offensively and defensively.
Look at that. He's down there talking to him right now, including Karl Malone. You see the look on Carl's face. Just in this final minute of the first period, it's 28-19.
I remember joking with Jerry last game, talking about, hey, when I played for him, everything he did, nothing really worked. I said, it's nice, coach, to see all the things you tried to teach me work for the Utah Jazz, because they didn't work with us.
That was a long time ago in Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
Brent Price, Bullard. That's the end of the period. It was tied at 17. At 4 minute mark of the first period. Since then it was 12-2. Utah leading 29-19 after the first quarter.
One more shot.
One more pass.
One more block.
One more chance to risk it all.
Because in the playoffs,
win one more time or you go home.
The NBA playoffs continue on TNT and TBS. Every game counts.
The momentum is shifting in this one.
Dude, get down. It's my chair. Let's go. I'm not playing games.
Okay, here we go again.
Oh, dude.
Outside.
Hey, those dog obedience classes really paid off.
Check out that game last night. What a finish.
Yeah.
Let's keep it light. Want to go for five?
Sure. Would that be minutes or miles?
Wow. Hey, you want to slow it up?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm having a little problem here.
Barry, we've gone like 50 yards.
Yeah, it's these shoes, man. I mean, this was cool, man. I'm glad we did this, but there's something I got to do. The shoes or something.
Barry, come on, man.
I got things to deal with. I gotta get out of here, man.
So you know it's there.
It's there. $100,000.
What's the split?
There's no split. $100,000, $100,000, $100,000.
I can't go in there. They know me.
Let's get Sal.
Sal.
Sal. That's beautiful.
$100,000. Rich, chewy caramel, creamy milk chocolate, and crispy little crunchies.
Here, Grandpa.
Nice work, Sally. Keep one for yourself, kid.
$100,000 from Nestle. Now that's rich.
Welcome back to the Delta Center. We are sitting now with Kay Malone, wife of Karl Malone. And Kay, I said I had to come visit you right away because I won't see you here in the second half. Why is that?
Well, it's kind of a superstition. We just, it's just mostly like if they're down, and everybody around me here always tells me to go down because when I go down, they win. So you won't see me after halftime.
And they're enjoying a nice 10-point lead right now. Bob, Reggie, back to you guys.
Thanks, Dee. Everybody gets into the act. And believe me, players' superstition, they work, and they're for real. Don't let anybody kid you.
I wouldn't let you kid.
No, no. Listen, I knew if I didn't have pancakes, I was done for the night.
Pancakes? You're a health food nut now. Looking into Elijah Wan. Elijah Wan against Ostertag. Ball stripped, foul in Utah. Don Howard Eisley. Almost a reverse of the scores, certainly a reverse of the way the game went from game one. The score at the end of one period in game one was 27-24 Rockets. The score at the end of game one here, 29-19 Jazz. Free throws have made a great deal of difference in the first half. Plus, it has been now about 5 minutes, nearly 5 minutes, since Houston has had a field goal. The only field goal was a Willis layup about 5 minutes ago. Houston shooting only 37, now 35%. Plus Houston has 7 turnovers to Utah's 2. Very clear story of the game. Antoine Carr missing, Ostertag putting it back. That's what Utah will have to have if they are in fact going to make the run for an NBA championship.
In the regular season, they were plus 10 rebounding. That's the way they have to do it. Offensive rebounding. Ostertag.
Elijah Wan looking for something. Lost it again. Interior defense is dominating. Eisley pass Price. Rebound Barkley. 14-2 run here for Utah.
Good transition defense that time for the Houston Rockets.
31-19 Jazz. Biggest lead of the game. Houston looking for threes. Finding it. That's a two, however, as Eddie Johnson stepped on the line. That's his first open look at the basket. He's played about 5 or 6 minutes on the floor, Eddie Johnson. Jazz by 10. Eisley off the pick from Carr. Ostertag got his 7-2 frame up there to get the rebound. That's his third board in limited minutes off the bench.
And two offensive. That gives him another look.
Shot clock at 10. Working that pick and roll. Both. Brent Price went down, left Eisley open. Eisley misses the jumper. Now Drexler back in the game and on the run, fouled by Eisley.
Not a bad foul by Eisley because it's very difficult to stop Clyde Drexler. He's got his head down. He looks like he's not paying attention. All he can just stab in the ball, but he really is on top of things when he's dribbling up court.
That's the third on Eisley, and Stockton's gonna and is back in the game. Shandon Anderson also with his first appearance of the night for the Utah Jazz. Shandon wears number 40. Drexler's turnaround jumper. Rebound Ostertag. That's four boards for Ostertag. 10 minutes to go in the half. Utah by 10. It's what most people expected the first half of game one to be. It was just about the reverse. Stockton kicks to the corner. Shandon Anderson. Anderson, the second year, 25-year-old from the University of Georgia. Shot 54% from the field in the regular season. 12-point Jazz lead. Elijah Wan. They just triple-teamed him there. Shandon Anderson nearly had the steal. 11 on the shot clock for Houston. Timeout. Shandon Anderson just with a couple of minutes of playing time here. He was the last substitute to enter the game. Gets an open look.
T-Wolves, Sonics. Coverage begins tomorrow night at 8:30.
Mm-hmm.
Introducing the amazing four-wheel drive RX 300. Not just another SUV. It's like no other vehicle on Earth.
Winning the Super Bowl took some advice, harmony, teamwork, like the team at Olathe Lincoln Mercury. They're number one in some advice and savings, like these Hall of Fame deals.
The best value in the market is here. Grand Marquis. Now for a limited time, only $19,988.
Take it from me, Jan Stenerud. The people's choice is Olathe Lincoln Mercury, just east of I-35 on Santa Fe, next to Olathe Ford.
Lifetime knows that mothers are loaded with tons of wisdom, intuition, and advice.
Mom said always wear clean underwear.
Don't run with scissors, you'll poke your eye out.
Now Mom's advice could pay off, and Lifetime's Mom Always Said sweepstakes. Tell us what your mom always said, and you can win a trip for two to California's Ojai Valley Inn and Spa. So celebrate Mother's Day with Lifetime.
Mother's Day is right around the corner, and luckily so is the Baptist Bookstore, where you'll find everything to show Mom how much you care. We're making memories for Mom at Everyone's Place for Christian Values, the Baptist Bookstore.
Ernie Johnson in Atlanta. Earlier tonight on TNT, Charlotte got 25 from Anthony Mason, beat the Hawks 92-85. After being swept by Atlanta in the regular season, the Hornets can now sweep the playoffs. Here's Dave Cowens.
You know, we're just turning a lot of doubters into believers, and that's what we're trying to do here. And I hope, and the crowd was just tremendous for us. I mean, they really did a great job for us tonight.
Hornets up 2-0. Game 3 Tuesday night on TNT. The winner of that series meets Chicago or New Jersey. Game 2 of that series tomorrow on NBC. Back to the Delta Center, Bob and Ray.
Thank you very much, Ernie. 33-21 here, 9:30 to go in the first half of play. The Rockets able to score only 21 points so far. By the way, Houston trailed by just 2 when Barkley came in. They're now down 12, and Charles is 0 for 3. Charles on the bench now. Ball loose on the floor again. We're going to have a jump ball. That's just typical of the defense that's been played by Utah in this first half of play. It has been an amazing difference, Reggie.
I tell you what, Karl Malone, we didn't see it in game one, but tonight has come out and set the tone. Look at the footwork, the effort, and his troops are falling in line. They're playing ball all over the place. Floor burns, scraping it down.
Drexler wins the tip, Eddie Johnson. Barkley! That's as high as I have seen Charlie jump since maybe 1986.
I'm going to do that. I haven't seen that since Auburn.
That's the round mound rebound there.
Ooh,
that was something. I'm stunned. Watch this. Thank goodness for replay.
I'm going to look real close. I think maybe he climbed somebody's back because Charlie was getting up. He was elbow high over the rim, Bob.
6'4 and a half.
Oh, my.
What sports hernia? You know, there's a Houston columnist said he was faking it the whole thing so he could get two weeks rest and then kind of lull Utah into expecting not to be able to play. No, I think that's true. But knowing Charles, he would attempt anything. That was spectacular. 10-point Jazz lead. Stockton, when he went to the bench, is handling the ball now. The Utah run that got them out to their big lead occurred with Stockton on the bench. Isley with three fouls went back to the bench, and John's back in. 4 on the shot clock. 3-second violation. Ten-point Jazz lead, 8:28 to go, first half. If you're Houston, you have to be thinking, we have not played well. We certainly haven't shot well, and we're down 10. Turned it over 7 times. Still in this thing very deeply.
Absolutely. And weathering a pretty solid start by the Utah Jazz, only down by 10, still in very much in contact with this basketball game.
Barkley against Antoine Carr, 7 on the shot clock. Fadeaway got the foul first. Charles will go to the line. That's on Antoine. Carr had himself a nice effort off the bench in only 14 minutes, had 9 points and 3 rebounds. And in the second half, Carr, in that third period particularly, Carr was the only offense that Utah could find in game one. Mary's numbers. That's the fourth team foul this period on Utah. Houston has yet to commit a foul. That's a flip-flop from quarter number one.
Absolutely. Very different basketball game tonight from a lot of respects.
Barkley, who came out to practice free throws. You hear the jeers in the face of these fans here at the Delta Center. Misses his first one here tonight. He said he was very disappointed in his free throw shooting in game number one.
And he really did spend about 15, 20 minutes shooting free throws. And it's a tough situation because they still had about 100 fans around booing him on his free throws.
I wish he could play longer than he's going to be able to play. I mean, the truth is he is getting older. But Charles, 35 in his 14th year. He says he'll be back next year. Well, near steal. Malone. Shandon Anderson missed the tip. Out of bounds. Houston ball. Down nine. Houston with a mini run here.
Great second effort by Shandon Anderson trying to get that tip back in there.
I like the headline of one of the Houston papers that said, Utah, Houston, you have a problem. Took me back to the moonshot days. Apollo 13. Maloney missing. Utah ball. 7:36 to go, first half. Houston's shooting has definitely deteriorated here, and Houston now shooting 36%. There are the numbers for the quarter.
And a lot of that you have to give credit to Utah for, because they're chasing a lot harder. And in game one, that exact play on three occasions in the first half, stocked into the corner, was missed. Tonight they banged it three times already.
Olajuwon has been stifled in this first half. Maloney faked the pass, took the three. Eddie Johnson upset because he wanted that shot. Maloney took it anyway. Wanted a foul, didn't get it. Went over the backboard, Utah ball.
And again, the effort defensively, you saw on Maloney's jump shot, John Stockton came from quite a ways to challenge him. John Stockton giving help down low. Look at the fake. And on the pass, watch Stockton's effort going out to Maloney. That is hustle.
Probably a good decision by Maloney on that replay. You saw the defender was going to be in the face of Eddie Johnson. Drexler got the steal. The foul's going to be on John Stockton. That's his first. And we've got a timeout on the floor with 6:50 to go in the first half. The Rockets have pulled to within nine.
Its beauty will draw you in. Its new engine will pump the bowels of your heart. And the line that separates man from machine will disappear. Completely. Introducing a new kind of LS400. You've never felt so connected to a car.
The movie event of the summer bring you Score From Deep, a sweepstakes of earth-shattering proportions. Visit any Best Buy for an entry form and see Deep Impact in theaters May 8th.
CARE is here to help people help themselves. The progress is really remarkable in Zambia. People work so hard to improve their lot in life. And these people are really willing to learn now. I think Dikembe Mutombo understands that the power inside these people is really phenomenal. I know Mutombo will bring home one important thought. A little care can make a world of difference.
35-24, Utah. Houston trying to get back into the game. Just a time to remind you here, tomorrow at 6:30, this is an unsolicited testimonial. This is an outstanding original movie, TNT, The Day Lincoln Was Shot. Rob Morrow is the star. Do well to catch that. 35, that's my Siskel Ebert thing. Neil Theus Siskel Ebert.
You're just a company man.
I am. I'm not naked, thank goodness. In
recognition for being a company man. Drexler's first game, 22-3-6. Drexler has been quiet in this game, however. 6 points, 3 rebounds.
Houston so far in this basketball game started the game off 2-for-2 from the three-point line. Since then has gone 0-for-7, shooting 22% from out there.
Stockton off that pick and roll with a penetration. He's going to shoot the floater. Got his own rebound and put back. That's because Elijah Wan was definitely tied up by Antoine Carr. It was Utah begging for foul calls in game number one. Now it's Houston here in game two.
And I thought in game one, we were going to have to go up there and take a baby rattle over to the Utah Jazz bench.
Well, that's what Jerry Sloan said, too. He says, our players spent more time whining about calls than they did play.
He said, listen, get a towel and wrap it around your neck and cry in the towel, but don't cry to the referees.
Elijah Wan really does not look like himself tonight. You could see on that free throw, he barely bent his knees. Now remember, his left knee is the one he had the surgery on. The right knee had swollen in the last week of the regular season because, said the Dream, I had been favoring my left knee so much. So he's got swelling in both knees. Rudy Tomjanovich said he seemed to be fine, however, after game number one, but he does look a little bit stiffer than usual.
And he has to be in the worst game shape of his career at this point of the season.
95 when they won the title. He was not only, I think, the best NBA player in the NBA that year, but he was one of the best conditioned. Shandon Anderson from the corner. Elijah Wan gets the rebound. That's five boards for the Dream.
Well, they depend on Dream for so many things, Bob, offensively and defensively.
Ostertag's been pounding on him down there. He's going to try that turnaround jumper. First time we've seen that tonight, and that is a major part of his arsenal.
Well, I tell you what, if you had to give him a shot, though, that's the shot you want him to take. First of all, keeps him off the offensive boards and gives your team a better opportunity to rebound.
Jazz by 8, 5:44 to go in the first half. Ostertag with the offensive tip, miss. Drexler, I thought he was going to take it to the hole there. Instead, gives it up to Charles. Drexler, Barkley, Elijah Wan, three future Hall of Famers on the floor right now for Houston. Drexler. Russell with a rebound. Jazz by 8. 5:19 to go in the half. Very quickly down court to Malone underneath. Too far underneath. Maloney with a rebound to Barkley. Barkley against Ostertag to Drexler. And how about Shandon Anderson? Nice defensive play, but he's called for the foul.
Great hustle by Shandon Anderson on the break. They had a sure basket, probably a foul, but look at the effort. Running the floor, second effort, running behind Clyde, really fending off an obvious bucket. And with a man in front of him, he could have taken Clyde out as hard as he wanted to and never would have got a flagrant on that one because it was not a clear path to the basket.
Drexler hits the free throw. Jeff Hornacek coming back into the game. Clyde Drexler is going to retire at the end of the year to take over as head coach at his alma mater, the University of Houston. 10-time All-Star, 5th in active scoring, 22,195 points, 4th all-time in steals. I could go on and on. What a great career at Portland and then at Houston for Clyde the God.
And one of the nicest guys in the league.
6-0 run now by Houston. They pull to within 6. That's open. They left it open. Houston did in the first game, and Utah missed that shot from the corner. Here, Shandon Anderson has hit a couple.
And they're making sure that Stockton can't turn that corner. They're running that defense an awful long way to try to stop that pick and roll.
Elijah Wan tried to spin to the basket, lost it. Bad pass from Shandon Anderson. Then he commits the foul. Anderson tried to give that ball to the big man. Too low, Carl Malone, who couldn't handle it. Anderson is part of the active second unit, though. He and Brian Russell and Howard Eisley can really get him running, as you saw. Jazz by 9, 4:35 to go in the half. How about this? The Rockets have committed no team fouls this half. Utah's already independent this quarter, I should say. No team fouls by Houston with 4:35 to go in the second period.
And that's not a bad thing, Bob, especially when you think about how lackadaisical the Jazz came out in game one tonight. Totally different. And when you're that aggressive, you're going to have more fouls. Right now, in the quarter, Houston 6-for-9. Utah
with 0.
How about that?
That's tremendous.
And with that free throw, it's 7-for-10. 8-point Jazz lead. 4:28 to go, first half. Bad pass by Malone, nearly stolen by Drexler. Deflected into the hands of Hornacek. Drexler in his face, Hornacek shooting it anyway. Rebound, Kevin Willis. That's his 6th board. Kevin's been quiet compared to game one here in this first half. He's going to take Ostertag to the hoop. It's stripped again. Utah is known for their ability, particularly Karl Malone, known for their ability to strip the ball on drives to the basket. We've really seen a plethora tonight.
Well, right now, they're just converging down in the middle, 3 and 4 guys at a time, to stop anything happening from the Rockets driving to the bucket.
What about that? Houston shooting 35%. Kevin Willis gets that perimeter shot to go down, and Kevin had, that's his first perimeter basket. He had a lay-in early in the ball game. It's a 6-point Jazz lead. Offensive foul. Ball by Hugh Evans. Charles Barkley with great and very vocal approval.
A very tough situation. Anytime they run that UCLA cut off of Karl Malone, Maloney has to go through an enormous pick, and if he's a little bit late, Stockton gets a layup under the basket.
Foul called on Malone, his first. 6-point Jazz lead. Houston making a comeback here in second period. Kevin Willis tried to jump it, fouled by the 7-2 Ostertag.
And what I liked about that, Bob, was the fact that Kevin Willis went into Ostertag's body first, got the contact, and then went through him to get the foul. Watch this. Really quick, he's going to bump his body into him, then go up through his arms. That is a planned foul. He knows that he has that situation.
Kevin Willis, 13 year, 36 years old. Here are the games by the half in games 1 and 2.
And what you notice right there is Willis really carried them in the first half. And then, of course, Barkley and Olajuwon picking it up for the Rockets in the second half and finishing the game out. What I like most in that is the fact that Olajuwon didn't have a great game, but he got those 5 blocks and the majority of them in the second half.
Hakeem on the bench right now. Olajuwon with 8 points and 5 boards. Drexler got his hip out there to really bump Karl Malone. Nothing coming easy tonight. Man's basketball. That's 3 fouls on Clyde. He also carrying a technical.
Bob, I gotta tell you, there are so many times that players do some serious acting out there. Many times, Karl Malone would run right through that pick, but he knows the referees are on it, they're on top of it, and right now, I thought he really flopped quite nicely.
Well, I've given Drexler the credit of an offensive lineman. Stockton from the corner.
And then when you look at it, as poorly as Houston's playing, they're only down 4. If they go into halftime with this type of effort, they've got to be feeling pretty good about themselves.
Houston on a 10-3 run the last 3.5 minutes. Willis working on Foster, who just came into the game. Here's Ellie. That's a big 3. It is now a 1-point Jazz lead.
And what I like about that is it was off of a swing, a pass out, and then a kick over.
Malone's turnaround jumper, rebound Ellie. Rockets have a chance to claim the lead. 2:33 to go in the half. Malone started 0-for-3, then 2-2. Now he is 0-for-4. He's been streaky tonight. Talking about Carl. Into Kevin Willis working on Foster. Malone can't hold it, but saves it back inbounds to Jeff Hornacek. Jazz by a point. Hornacek kicks to Foster. He hit some perimeter shots in the opening moments of the game. 2 in a row, as a matter of fact. 2 minutes to go, first half. Karl Malone, I told you, started 0-for-3, then went 2 out of 2, then 0 out of 4. So if this pattern is going to be history of any kind of lesson, Karl will now go on a streak there. So let's see if Kay Malone sticks around for the second half. She told D she might not.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the amazing RX 300. It's escape. Bring it to me. Win me my prize.
The amazing four-wheel drive RX 300.
Close the gates!
Not just another SUV. It's like no other vehicle on Earth.
Check out that game last night? What a finish.
Yeah.
Let's keep it light. Want to go for five?
Sure. Would that be minutes or miles?
Wow. Hey, you want to slow it up?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm having a little problem here.
Barry, we've gone like 50 yards.
Yeah, it's these shoes, man. I mean, this was cool, man. I'm glad we did this, but there's something I gotta do. It's the shoes or something.
Barry, come on, man.
I got things to deal with. I gotta get out of here, man.
A lot of times when something goes wrong with your car, you know it right away. But some parts, like shock absorbers, tend to wear out gradually over time. So gradually that many drivers fail to realize just how worn their shocks have become. So rather than wait till it's painfully obvious that you need new shocks, stop by your nearest AutoZone. Right now, when you buy three Gabriel Gas Rider shocks or struts, you get the fourth one free, only at AutoZone.
The NBA playoffs on TNT, brought to you by your local AutoZone stores. For the right parts at the right price, look no further than AutoZone. And by Lexus. The future of Lexus is here. Fasten your seatbelts.
It's a three-point Jazz lead, 2 minutes, 1 second remaining in the first half. We'll continue NBA action tomorrow on Turner's Court. Pre-game show at 8:30 Eastern Time, then the Wolves and the Sonics at 9 Eastern Time, followed by Inside the NBA. How about this shooting percentage? Utah in this quarter, 29%, 6 of 21 from the floor, and no free throw attempts.
No free throw attempts, and they've committed 10 on their own in this quarter. Houston only one.
Inside to Willis, ripped beautifully by Stockton. Kevin went to the jump hook and missed it. Credit that play to John Stockton.
But I still think that even though they're fouling quite a bit more, that their effort and their intensity level will help them in the latter part of this basketball game.
Stockton falls, passes, another assist as he gets Floor Burn, and Shannon Anderson builds the lead for the Jazz now. Back to five. That's seven assists for John in this first half. Still posting Kevin Willis, despite the fact he's not shooting well this first period, or this first half. Foster in the air. Missed the layup.
Oh.
Hornacek looking for Malone. Posted deep. Barkley blocked it, but fouled him. Look at the crowd. The crowd, this is about as much noise as we've heard from this crowd. They just love to talk to Charles.
And they're getting into it. Charles, I thought, playing pretty good defense, but he allowed Carl to get too far in there. And if you notice Carl's body language, how deep he was into Barkley's stomach with his body, that is why he had to reach so far to foul him. It's not body contact up high, it's the body contact from the chest to the stomach. That's where the referee called the foul.
Carl Malone is 2 out of 3 from the free throw line, only 3 of 10 from the field. He does have 6 rebounds in this first half. Carl Malone, certainly a future Hall of Famer himself. One of only 5 players in the history of the league to score 27,000 points and get 11,000 rebounds. The others, Kareem, Wilt, the Big E, Elvin Hayes, and Moses Malone. What company. Utah on a 6-0 run since it was 40-39. A minute to go in the half. Willis alone, but Malone recovered because Ellie didn't get it to him in time. Illegal defense. Call against the Jazz. That's the second. This will be a free throw. Coming up on the Nike Halftime Report, Ernie Johnson, Kenny Smith, and Brian Hill recap all of today's playoff action. Cleveland, Indiana, Atlanta, Charlotte, San Antonio, Phoenix. Eddie Johnson will shoot the free throw. He's an 83% free throw shooter.
And Houston will get the ball back. Trailing now by six with this possession, could cut the lead to four. Biggest lead in this ball game has been 12 by Utah, down to four. They led 33-21. 42 seconds remaining.
Two-for-one situation here. If they shoot the ball before 34 seconds.
Willis working inside. Well, that interior defense has been incredible, but that time, Kevin Willis used his not inconsiderable strength to hold onto that ball.
But the defense stopped him. He made a great offensive adjustment to get the ball and shoot it where he did.
Foster working hard on the offensive boards, draws the foul.
Foster working it, had a very nice first quarter. Coming out here in the second quarter, working the boards, getting underneath, offensive rebounds for the Utah Jazz and really helping them out right now. Utah seven offensive boards, Houston only three. One of the key areas that Rudy said that we have to have control of is that offensive rebound, and you cannot give the Utah Jazz, with their ability to run offense and really stick to their game plan, a second opportunity to score.
Rudy T, what a great job he did preparing his team for game one, and that his the compliments for his preparation came from the players, from Barkley. Charles Barkley had a funny line about Rudy T. He says, a lot of coaches in the league, and we know who they are, want $300 a day meal money. Rudy T just wants to coach from the mouth of Barkley.
But I guess he wouldn't turn it down if it was offered to him, huh?
7 seconds in the period. Maloney, all the way to the hoop. There's time. No, no time for the shot. No time for the shot. Jazz lead it by five at the half. Utah had led by 12. Houston made a bit of a mini run there in the second period and have made it anybody's game at 47-42 at the half. In just a minute, Rudy Tomjanovic is still on the court, still talking to Hugh Evans. Let's stay with this. Let's stay with it.
Bob, he is really getting after Hugh because that last drive by Maloney, really, there was quite a bit of contact underneath the basket. Watch Maloney drive to the bucket off of a couple of nice little stutter steps and a spin, and then the contact right around the basket area, right there. Look at that.
Yeah, he's hit hard.
And many times in the closing of a half, a closing of a quarter, referees will not give you anything.
Good call, Reggie. That's exactly what Rudy T was saying. Larry Smith there on the left is the man who is defending Rudy from picking up a T. Right after this commercial timeout, we'll go to our studios in Atlanta for Nike Halftime Report.
Well, I've decided. Tonight's the night I'm going to pop the question.
That's great. So did you get the ring yet?
No, I had a better idea. I wanted to get her something that says, I'm really in this for the long haul. It's a train.
What? I'm making a commitment here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing RX 300. It's escape. Bring it to me. We meet like a prize.
The amazing four-wheel drive RX 300.
Close the gates!
Not just another SUV. It's like no other vehicle on Earth.
This here freight train, Pete Pablo. Me, I'm Motif. There's only one drink fat enough to quench our thirst, and that's Turbo Sport 7.
God, genius, the can's upside down.
Don't talk to me like a child. I played Hamlet at Cambridge.
Once again, you've ruined my concentration.
Excuse me, what's my motivation?
When you're thirsty, trust your gut, not some actor.
That's it, I am going to my trailer.
So, guys, what do we want to do this weekend?
Let's go to the beach.
It happened at 10 till 6 on a Tuesday night.
Okay, that's
just before the steamed carrots were served.
Beach.
Guys, it's important. Yes, this is Louisa. What are you saying?
A phone call she would always remember.
We got the house. We got the house.
For a free guide to help you on the path to homeownership, call the Fannie Mae Foundation. We're showing America a new way home.
Well, after losing game one by 13, the Utah Jazz at home, leading at the break 47-42. The mailman has 9 points. Utah trying to even the series at a game apiece. We welcome you to our Atlanta studio. Ernie Johnson along with Kenny Smith and Brian Hill, the head coach of the Vancouver Grizzlies. We welcome you to the Nike Halftime Report. Coach, a little more inspired effort from the Jazz this time around, I'd say.
Yeah, I think it jumps out at you right away that they're really forcing the action in this game. And I think at the offensive end of the floor, you see that they're really pushing the ball more. Here, Jeff Hornacek getting out on the break. They all know that Karl Malone is always running the floor, always filling that lane, and they drop it off. Defensively, doing a great job with Akeem, not really doubling, but ready to dig out when he puts the ball on the floor, come and help, forces a turnover, another thing that leads for them to get out on the break.
So the Utah Jazz with a 5-point lead over that team with the heart of a champion, the Houston Rockets.
You got to be happy, though, if you're the Rockets, because you've really took the best shot. It's like in a heavyweight title fight. You get all of these big 1-2 punches, and all of a sudden you're still there. You're still in the ball game, and Houston's right there.
Should be a nice final 24 minutes. It's 47-42 in favor of Utah. Meantime, earlier tonight, the Atlanta Hawks and the Charlotte Hornets playing at the Hive, and the Hornets looking for a 2-0 lead after being swept in the regular season by Atlanta. The Hawks, just like game one, out to a great start. Steve Smith had 22 on the night, and he gets free early. They would lead by 15, and then the Hornets come back. Lottie Zivots uncontested with the stick back jam. They're down by 5 at the half. And then they keep coming back. Len Rice follows his own shot. Nice fundamentals. 24 points. They're up 70-68. Anthony Mason had some big buckets late. Working the offensive glass. Flicks it back in. He had 25 on the night. And the Charlotte Hornets win game two. They're up 2-love. Holding serve at home, 92-85. Mason goes for 25 and 7. Smith goes for 22 for the Atlanta Hawks. But it's now a 2-games-to-none lead after Atlanta swept the regular season series. And you see they're scoring almost 20 points fewer per game. Field goal percentage down, three-point percentage down as game three looms on Tuesday on TNT. What is Anthony Mason's take on the turnaround?
Everybody know the playoffs at a different level. I'm not going to say we laid down during the regular season. You can't make no excuses. They dominated us regular season. This team went home early last year. They didn't want to go home early this year. So they're playing good basketball. I don't want to make no excuses. We're just playing well.
I got that, I think. Meantime, the Cleveland Cavaliers and the Indiana Pacers this afternoon. Indiana wins it 92-86 to take a 2-0 lead. In that series, Reggie Miller had 18. Look at the turnovers. Cleveland with 18 to just 8 for the Indiana Pacers. They play game 3 on TNT Monday night. So a couple of teams with a chance to complete sweeps here as they hit the road. The Cleveland Cavaliers are home against the Pacers, who are up 2-0. Charlotte Hornets go to Atlanta trying to sweep. Let's look at both of these. Do you think Cleveland can stay alive and avoid the broom with Indiana right now, Coach?
I think Mike Fratello's got a tough job on his hands. They outshot Indiana today from the floor. They out-free-throwed them. They out-rebounded them. But they still couldn't get it done, and it was the turnovers that cost them. It's a young team. If they can feed off the emotion of the home crowd and get off to a good start, they have a chance, but it's a tough job.
Cleveland was able to win 2 games against Indiana at Gund Arena this year. How about the Hornets going to Atlanta now in search of the sweep at the Georgia Dome?
Well, the toughest game in any series is the closeout game. If you can close a team out because they're fighting for their lives, their NBA lives right there. So this is the toughest game, and I think it's going to be an advantage for Atlanta because the game is at home. If it was on the road, then I would say the brooms bring them out because everybody's ready to sweep you away.
I tell you what, Charlotte has dominated the second half in the series, outscoring the Hawks 92-70 in the first 2 games. Now, here is the latest on the breakup of the Bulls front. NBC Sports reported today that Iowa State head coach Tim Floyd may be closer to becoming Phil Jackson's successor. According to NBC, Floyd has contacted the trainer of the New Orleans Saints with an offer to join him in Chicago. Bulls PR director Tim Hallam tells Turner Sports that any talks of a coaching change are premature at this time. When the Nike Halftime Report continues, the highlights from the Valley of the Sun, Suns and Spurs game 2 when we come back.
This is not about fashion. This is about the soft, vulnerable, flimsy, fantastic human body, chasing perfection, and the hard, uncaring, physical world. This is about not having to wear your own sweat the whole game. This is about how something as small as how you feel can decide something as big as who wins. This is Nike Fit Performance Apparel. The evolution of skin.
New file, begin dictation.
Who are you talking to?
My computer.
I do that too sometimes.
No, you don't understand. I got this new software. I talk it types.
You talk it types?
I talk it types.
It's typing.
Because I'm talking.
What is it type?
Whatever I say.
So let me try.
No.
Why?
Because it's mine. Get your own.
Now when I talk, it types.
All across America, you're there to see us through. Just around the corner, a neighborhood Jiffy Lube.
You depend on your car, so trust it to Jiffy Lube. Jiffy Lube makes it easy. Every 3,000 miles.
3,000 miles, you make us smile. America's Jiffy Lube.
Drive in, drive out, drive on.
What's on tap for Sunday, you ask? Check this out on NBC. 12:30, the Knicks and the Heat, followed by the Blazers taking on Shaq and the Lakers. And then it's the Nets and Bulls at 5:30 Eastern time in Game 2 of their Eastern Conference first round best of five. What are we doing tomorrow night, you ask? How about a pregame show at 8:30, followed by the Timberwolves and the Sonics Game 2. Minnesota looking to even the score after getting thumped pretty good at Key Arena in Game 1 of that series. Western Conference action this afternoon, San Antonio and Phoenix at America West. And the Phoenix Bombers were at it. George McLeod hit 6 out of 7 on the day, including 4 out of 4 in the first half. Rex Chapman going up top to Antonio McDice, 70-58 Phoenix. And San Antonio starts chipping away, going to the big guys. David Robinson, smooth jumper. Tim Duncan, who dominated Game 1 with 18 points in the fourth quarter, turnaround jumper. They're only down by 2. And late in the game, down 3, 10 seconds to play. Great look for Jaren Jackson, but he was cold all day. Only 4 out of 14 from the field, 3 out of 11 from beyond the arc. David Robinson and the Spurs fall 108-101, but they had already won the first game of that to at least gain a split on the road. Phoenix wins it by 7. Robinson goes for 23-16. Tim Duncan, 16-10 and 4 blocks. The difference for the Phoenix Suns, the Big Mac attack. McLeod and McDice in Game 1 and Game 2. You see the comparison of the numbers. 43 points they combined for in Game 2 as the Suns win, hitting 16 out of 26, and McLeod hitting all 6 of those 3-pointers. Game 3, Monday night, right here on TNT. Your take on the San Antonio Spurs performance today? I get the impression you think they maybe got satisfied with winning Game 1, Kenny.
Well, over the years, I think the Spurs sometimes seems like they have a lack of urgency. And I think if they would have won this game today, this could have really put them over the hump. If you look at here, you have Mark Bryan. He has a wide-open jump shot. David Robinson and Tim Duncan are inside. He misses the first shot. David misses the rebound. He gets the second, gets that block, gets the third shot. Now, Game 1, that would have never happened. Game 1, they would have stopped him. They would have blocked the shot. David would have grabbed the ball because it was more urgent. And I think in Game 2, the urgency kind of just relaxed a little bit, and they were able to have plays like that.
Series tied at a game apiece, and they go to San Antonio now for Game 3 and 4. Coach, you faced these teams, Phoenix and San Antonio, combined 8 times, 4 apiece. Which one is tougher to play?
Two great teams and two teams that are total opposites. To me, Phoenix, because they have the largest collection of players that can just make basketball plays. Guys that can penetrate, their big guys can all handle and finish. They have great perimeter shooting with McLeod, Scott, and Chapman. And they're a matchup nightmare. Their guards can post up. Their big guys can take you out on the floor. They're really a tough team to match up with.
San Antonio Spurs and the Phoenix Suns, that's a whale of a series in the first round of the Western Conference. Back to put the finishing touch on the Nike Halftime Report in just a second. The NBA playoffs continuing on TNT.
So it's called the AT&T $2 million shootout, huh?
Five shots, two mil.
$2 million.
Mm. It's the NBA Finals.
Two mil.
That could be me.
Just call 1-888-6-FINALS and you can win a trip to the NBA Finals and a shot at $2 million or thousands of other prizes. So call now.
Hey, Lenny, know what you could do with $2 million? You can move that basket higher and to the right.
Just call 1-888-6-FINALS now.
American Express Small Business Services, how can I help you?
How can I help you?
Right. We only work with small businesses.
Why don't we start with your cash flow?
And our equipment financing plan will help spread out the payments.
That'll definitely give you more flexibility.
How about setting up a line of credit?
We can do that.
Then I'll put you in touch with one of our CPAs so you can start getting ready for tax time.
We can always make adjustments when your situation changes.
Call 1-800-SUCCESS to find out how American Express Small Business Services can help you do more.
While we could give you a lot of reasons to buy performance friction carbon metallic disc brake pads from AutoZone, perhaps the most compelling is this. They simply stop shorter than any brand we've ever tested. Performance friction carbon metallic. Ask for them at AutoZone.
Grady and Son make the sweetest steaks around, the Gazette. Grady and Son's marinade gives their steak zing, the Gazette. Grady and Son cherish the secret to their tangy marinade, the Gazette.
Our secret is A1 sweet and tangy.
Grady and Daughter make the sweetest steaks around, the Gazette. The secret to great steak isn't just for great steakhouses anymore. A1, a marinade, a seasoning, a 136-year-old secret.
And welcome back. Remember, after the Rockets and Jazz, your night is not complete until you've watched Inside the NBA, hosted by Vince Cellini. He's got company tonight. Danny Shays, 17-year NBA veteran, and Hall of Famer Cheryl Miller on Inside the NBA. If you're on the net, you're surfing, check this out. CNN Sports Illustrated, the ultimate address for sports, CNNSI.com. After 24 minutes at the Delta Center. The Jazz, 47-42, third quarter, coming up.
Come on, let's go faster, faster. He's really driving us. He's killing us.
I'm pulling away from you.
It helps, though. I don't think I could do it on my own.
I know. This is the longest I've ever stuck with a workout program.
Well, they say motivation is the key.
You can do it. Come on, you bunch of boss brothers. I don't see any sweat.
No wonder you can never get a bike around here.
This is what you're working for.
Hey, little pumpkin, you are so cute, aren't you? Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Honey, look how cute.
Honey, wait a minute. I think he's going to say something. Say hi to Dad there. Say hi, Dad there. Come on, zoom in. Zoom in. I think he's going to say it. Zoom in. Hey, say hi to Dad there. Say hi, Dad there.
Oh, Daddy, you paid too much for that camcorder.
Circuit City. Experts in every department. Low prices all over the...
What was your experience at the Toyota dealership?
No problems. I mean, it was so easy. Well, there was no hype, there's no pressure, and I got exactly what I wanted.
Your Toyota dealer really makes it easy now with 4.9 APR for 60 months on Corolla, the most trusted car in the world. Or take a low-priced Corolla lease, just $159 a month for all this quality.
Is it your first Toyota?
No, it's actually our ninth Toyota.
Your ninth?
We've never had a Toyota breakdown since 1972.
So your Kansas City Metro Toyota dealer.
Do you have a disabling illness or injury that keeps you from returning to work? If so, you may qualify for Social Security disability benefits. Disability Advocates helps you get the payments you're entitled to, whether you've been turned down before or haven't applied. Our services cost you absolutely nothing until you receive payments, and there's no hassle for you. Our professionals cut through the red tape and represent your best interest to get the payments you deserve. All it takes is one phone call to DAI at 1-800-788-3910.
This program is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the National Basketball Association. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the expressed written consent of the National Basketball Association is prohibited.
Four ties, four lead changes all in the first 8 minutes of this game. Utah jumped out with a lot of aggressive play. Houston made a run there in the second quarter. It's a five-point Utah lead. The Utah Jazz with the best record in the NBA, home court advantage throughout. Lost that advantage when they lost game one. But Reggie, you said at the beginning of our ballgame that Utah would have to change things up here more than anything else to get back in it. They did that, it seems.
Absolutely. Jerry Sloan said, hey, listen, if we don't come out and stroke people and defend, we can't win. Tonight, so far in this game, they've done just that.
Take a look at this, and you see the results of that. First of all, the shooting percentage. That's because the Rockets have had the ball stripped. They've been contested on every kind of shot attempt they could take. The Jazz didn't shoot that much better, but their defense was so good. And look at the fast break points differential from game one.
I tell you what, game one, it was just the opposite. Houston Rockets had 13 fast break points. The Utah Jazz only two. Big difference in the effort from Utah tonight.
Charles Barkley was fined $10,000 for his conversation with the fans in the stands. He even went into the stands in game one before halftime, got right in the face of one of the fans particularly. Tonight, though, that's the fan there that has the license tag on. That would tend to get you. You see they're working on him tonight. Charles showing a great deal more patience.
And sometimes, Bob, it's better to let the fans talk to the back of your head.
You've had some fans talking to you.
I've been there.
You know that one. Dee Lynam had a chance to talk to Rudy T of Houston just a moment ago.
Rudy, obviously at the end of the first half, you were very upset. What bothered you most?
Well, that's one play. I thought the guy got fouled, but I'm satisfied with the first half. We knew it was going to be a war, and we fought back. Doing a good job on the boards. Got some guys in foul trouble. Just got to do better with our patience. And get better shots on offense. But I feel very fortunate. I feel good about how things are going.
Good luck in the second half.
Rudy Tomjanovich. Players Brent Price, Charles Barkley, or really to a man, said they really appreciated not only the job that Rudy Tomjanovich did getting them ready for game one, but the entire coaching staff. They did play a great game one, but they're trailing here by five. Going into the second half at the Delta Center, Utah trailing in this first round series, one game to none, losing the first one, 103-90. Elijah Wan's been stymied in the middle of the first half. See how he does against Foster. Up and under, can't get a shot off. 8 on the shot clock. Perimeter shot from Drexler, doesn't go. Foster rebound. That's a repeat of how the game started. Want to say, inside, deep, Malone. Missed the layup. Houston ball.
I tell you what, Karl Malone couldn't get any deeper. Had the shot he wanted, just muffed it just a little bit, though. Tonight, 3 for 12, struggling offensively, getting the ball in the hole, but his presence is different. He's their leader tonight. He's playing, at least from an emotional standpoint, like the ex or the MVP of the league.
He just stole it while you said that from Kevin Willis. Stockton gets it on the easy basket at the other end.
See, Bob, that's why I was stalling a little bit, because I knew he was about to do something.
On cue. 49-42 Utah, opening moment second half. Along with D-Lineup, Reggie Bias, Bob Neal with you from the Delta Center in Salt Lake City. Elijah Wan. Defense right out of the game tonight. Bullard, pull-up jumper. Willis with the board, but look at that. Stripped again by John Stockton. Gonna have a jump ball. We were talking about Elijah Wan not being very involved in the game. In 19 minutes of playing time, Akeem has had only 5 shots, has made only 3.
And a lot of times they've been playing him single coverage.
He's had the touches.
He's had the touches, and he's had the look. Just not real quick. Doesn't look like he has anywhere near the leg speed that he's had in the past.
Back in the day, as you say, Clyde Drexler would win this jump ball. Even with Greg Foster.
I tell you what, but you, as we said, Greg Foster knows how to steal a tip, and that ball there was on its way up.
He stole it. He's won 12 straight tips at the beginning of the ballgame, Foster. That was a blatant steal.
It's just timing. He gets it just as it's getting ready to get to its climax.
Elijah Wan, he got buried in there deep this time. Foster had no recourse.
But a good foul. Why let Elijah Wan get started with something down low easy? Foster laid some wood on him nice and hard, and that's going to make Olajuwon take it out of bounds. Look at this defense. Moving his body. He, Olajuwon can't be denied, so Foster does the next best thing, and that's hammering.
And didn't give him a chance for a shot attempt,
exactly.
So it just sidelines out of bounds.
Exactly.
Akeem looking for somebody to be posted on the corner, made the drive and the kick, and it just went harmlessly out of bounds. Look at Rudy Tomjanovich's face.
Bob, I thought it was coming to me. I guarantee if I'd have got it, I would have shot it.
Oh, I know. You walked in here the other day after practice. You hadn't even practiced anything. It says, hey, Bob, busted a three. You guys never forget. Hornacek with fancy dribbling almost lost it. Nine on the shot clock. Hornacek goes back to it. The runner was stripped by Willis, who now leads the break with Drexler. Smartly gave it up to Drexler. Mid-range jumper, Maloney.
He's in a lot of guys you would say, hey, don't stop and shoot a 15-footer. Go and take it to the bucket. But Matt Maloney is very good at a stop and pop from that distance. I'd rather see him shoot that than try to drive to the bucket.
Right back, though, John Stockton slips inside of Maloney and gets the easy lay-in. That's two layups for John Stockton in this third period. 53-44, Jazz by nine.
And Maloney's looking at Willis saying, hey, you've got to give me help. You got to bump that color cutter.
10 on the shot clock. Olajuwon Drexler. Olajuwon set the pick. Karl Malone with a rebound. The Jazz came out and just fell on their faces collectively in the third quarter of game number one, and were outscored 28-14 in that period. They're not going to let that happen here tonight. They build a five-point halftime lead to 11, and Houston gets a timeout.
And Bob, that half-turn following jumper by Karl Malone in the low post changes his game, gives another guy a different look. It's almost impossible to stop when he's on. Jazz, getting it back together.
No one taught me more about teamwork than my dad. They called him Mr. Me because he never smiled. He didn't smile when he volunteered to coach the kids in the neighborhood. He didn't smile when he drove the team to every game. Or when he worked with kids for hours on his own time. He showed me anyone can make a difference if they just get involved. I'll tell you something else about my dad. He's got a great smile.
Team up with your community.
Yeah.
With formidable strength and a distinctly individual style, this Sierra is the most powerful half-ton truck in GMC's history. Sierra gives you the style to stand apart from the herd and a power to pull it. Sierra by GMC, putting you comfortably in command.
I won't rest until every thirsty beer-drinking adult has a cold Coors Light in his hands. Rest. Rest is for the peanut vendors and the nacho guys. The folks who frost-brew Coors Light, they don't rest until it's perfectly refreshing. And it's my job to get it to you that way. Oh, there's no rest for the beer man, not until every fan here is refreshed.
Joey, you ready?
I think everyone here is pretty refreshed, right?
The NBA playoffs on TNT, brought to you by Dutch Boy Paints. Give your home the lasting look of Dutch Boy. And by GMC, putting you comfortably in command.
Well, they're having a better time here tonight, painted face and all, at the Delta Center. 55-44, 11-point lead.
Scores, Bob, find a way to change and alter their game. He ended the half with this same exact play, a fall away, half turn off the wrong leg jumper. And that's how Carl mixes and matches his game with what's working for him. It's something that he may go on.
Only 4 of 13 from the floor. .45 to go in the third quarter. Maloney working on Stockton, kicking to Bullard. At 6'10", he got the shot off, but Foster with a rebound.
And at 6'10", that was a bad shot for Bullard. Didn't have that in his repertoire.
Hornacek defended by Drexler. Malone made the catch. Willis was pushing him out of position there. Malone wants that shot, can't get it. Four on the shot clock. How about the pass?
Oh, that's traveling.
wasting a great pass from Malone. He was in trouble and found Foster in the paint. Speaking of paint, in 28 minutes of play now, Houston has scored tonight only 8 points in the paint. We were documenting how neither Willis nor Olajuwon has been able to get off a shot down there, sometimes in only single coverage, and there it comes again. Stockton, here comes Bullard, look out. Well, Bullard couldn't get there.
But look at the effort defensively by the Utah Jazz, coming out playing like they want this game more than the Houston Rockets.
Look out, Hornacek and Drexler. Hornacek got his arm wedged underneath the wing of Clyde. The whistle sounded, though. Hornacek will get the foul. Now Rudy Tomjanovich is flirting with one himself as he talks to Hugh Evans, and Rudy T has one technical in this game already. This, by the way, is the biggest Utah lead of 13. They had led by 12 at 33-21.
Mano a mano, when players get locked up, nobody's going to give. I'm not going to let you have it. You're not going to let me have it. We'll just see who's going to get it in the end.
Utah foul as Olajuwon trying to get something done inside. Kevin Willis said thank you for the call. The personal is on Foster, his third.
Very important for Olajuwon to get involved in this game. Offensively, Bob, they're giving him a lot of touches down in the post and on many occasions playing them single coverage. He's got to make Greg Foster pay down there, and one of the ways is by getting to the line.
Houston only 1 of 5 from the floor with 3 turnovers in this period as Akeem, who's a career 24.12 rebound player, has only 16 points and 9.8 boards this year. Good numbers for any other center, but down for Akeem Olajuwon. Started the year after surgery on that left knee. Bullard got the offensive board, missed the putback. Goes again. Fouled is Bullard. Working hard, couldn't get it to go down, however.
Matt Bullard, now that's in his game. Get it, bang it around, and get it up into the bucket toward the areas. Look at this effort by Matt Bullard. Misses on the easy one, which he probably should have done, but right here gathers himself and takes it right back in. Another good look by our camera people. Right there, just great hustle all over the place.
Bullard hits a free throw. That's 14 fouls on Utah already in this quarter. We have 7:37 to go in the third, and this could become significant. Houston's a very good free throw shooting team themselves at 77%. They were fourth in the NBA this year. It is now a 10-point Jazz lead, their biggest lead of the game, moments ago at 13. Drexler and Hornacek, it's hot there tonight. Look at bodies flying in the paint.
I was just getting ready to say, players bumping each other, Bob, off the ball when there's no significant reason to do so. And then, of course, you see it going down the lane, another collision.
Ronnie Dunn, Hugh Evans talking it over. The foul is going to be on Drexler. And how about this? That's number 4 on Clyde Drexler. And Rudy T just realized that he's going to have to get Drexler out of there at first opportunity. 7:21 to go in the period. We're going to get Mario Elie in here in a minute. Hornacek's drive, Stockton open for the jumper over Bullard. Jazz by 12. Drexler with 4 personals.
Hornacek knows the foul situation. I guarantee you that's why he took Drexler to the hole. But defense stopped him, and he found his open man, Stockton.
Bullard for 3. Drexler with a near steal. Malone, Keith, Hornacek, Drexler, how about that? Got right in his face. Hornacek open for the 3, didn't get it. Sloan calling for an illegal defense, not getting it either. Malone working on Olajuwon, who's going to have a foul called on him, and that's 2 on Akeem. Now Elie is in. Drexler will sit down with his 4 personals.
I tell you what, it is a total disadvantage of any man when Karl Malone gets you that low into the basket. He's so wide, he's so quick, and when he turns, Bob, he turns with his elbows flared, so it's really difficult not to take the contact.
Hey, ask David Robinson. Maloney had some blood on his knee, speaking of contact in the game, had to get it cleaned off for health and safety reasons.
I tell you what, they say that West Coast basketball is no contact. They're not watching this basketball game because there's been a lot of contact in this ball game. Under the bucket and out front.
Jazz lead it by 13. If Malone hits this free throw, it'll be the biggest lead of the ball game by either team. Man has really keyed the scoring in this quarter has been John Stockton, who has 8 in the period.
Well, he averaged 16 points a game against them in the regular season and really kept them on their heels with his aggressive play tonight, doing the same thing.
Trying to get it inside. Here's where Houston has been denied in the paint, and once again it happens. Ellie open for the three, but he takes it inside, made an extra pass out of bounds. It'll be Houston ball with 9 left. Cloud applauding this Utah defense, particularly in the paint, Richard.
I tell you what, Foster's doing a great job. Olajuwon went to his famous patented spin and got no place because the defense was there.
Back to him again. There's the fadeaway. Rebound, Hornacek.
Forced him into going that way because he can't get anything anyplace else.
61-47, Utah. This is a reverse of the third period on Thursday night. Houston only 1 of 8 in this period. 1 field goal. Houston foul, it's on Kevin Willis. How about the third period on Thursday night? First of all, Utah missed their first 8 shots. We're only 3 of 16 overall. There's a good look at it right now. 0 for 3 on 3. Stockton had 3 turnovers, scored only 14 points. And now, with 5:58 to go in this third period, Houston has scored only 1 field goal. Shot clock at 10. Foster hands it to Keith. Execution. Utah 7 of 10 field goals in the quarter. They're coming in the paint and on breakaways. Crowd on their feet. Timeout, Houston. How about Greg Foster? Traded along with Chris Morris to Orlando for Ronnie Cicely. The Cicely wouldn't report. You see, Cicely played a little bit with New Jersey now, finally. And Greg Foster came back. He never wanted to leave because Utah's his 16th right. in his career, and he felt he had found a home here. He didn't want to leave anyway, so he was okay with the trade coming back. Chris Morris wasn't so okay, but actually learned to accept it himself.
Well, I tell you what, and the way the fans treated him when they had to come back was really big. Jerry Sloan said that he told the guys that you can come back and be upset, but that's not going to hurt anybody but you and us. But you can come back and maybe some good things will happen for you if you come back and do the right thing. And really, as far as the fans and this community and this organization have bettered their situations here in Utah.
Yeah, you see that nearly doubling his rebound totals, and that's effort. That comes from his
total effort.
Attitude.
And tonight playing a great job defensively on Olajuwon. Notice, no double teams.
What happens this time? Single team this time. Olajuwon finally gets to come across the paint in the way that he wants to and gets the little jump hook to drop.
Absolutely. No defense can stop that. Let him get too deep.
Houston has scored only 10 points in the last 9 minutes. Utah D. Stockton in the paint. Kicks to Keith. Olajuwon fouled him with the body before he got the block. Olajuwon had 6 blocks, 5 in this period in game 1.
Olajuwon trying to get to the game, but watch the low part of his body, not the upper part, right there, down low. A lot of times what you see is not just body to body, but the off arm of the defensive player in the guts of the offensive player. That's what the referee calls on many occasions.
Adam Keefe misses a free throw, shooting 81. He's had his best career ever, and to top that, he also is the proud father of twin daughters. So best year, twin daughters, not a bad year.
And I understand that Brian Russell has got a couple in the oven that are twins. So what's going on here?
It's water. We call water.
That air, that thin air.
Always said that. 64-49. Utah, we have a holding foul on Foster, and that is Greg Foster's 4th personal. That'll bring Greg Ostertag into the game, along with Howard Eisley, the 5-minute mark of period number 3.
Ostertag has some pretty big shoes to fill right now because Greg Foster has been doing a great job on both ends of the floor, and more than anything, he's been physical down low. Ostertag, that big body, has a lot of miles to give, could do the same right now and help his club.
Foster, 7 points, 5 boards. Olajuwon misses the free throw. 14th year for Akeem. He played on that great Phi Slamma Jamma team at the University of Houston. They went to the Final Four under Guy Lewis in 82 and 83. Clyde Drexler and Larry Michaud, I think is how you pronounce his name. It's been so long, I almost forgot, was the third man in that five slamma jamma there at Houston back in the early 80s. Remember the plaid coat of Guy Lewis, too.
And the plaid pants.
That's right. Of course, I was wearing plaid pants then, so I didn't think that was that unusual.
Oh, my God.
I was. 11 on the shot clock, 4:47 to go in the period. Should have known me, then.
Yeah, but did you have the white shoes on?
Well,
that's scary, Bob. Please
maybe.
Don't tell me.
Maybe. Oh, give and go. Pick and roll, really. And Ostertag missed the jack.
Give
gracious.
Me a break.
Gracious.
Come on.
7-2. Come on. That's right. Come on. He takes a lot of heat here. He's booed in the last home regular season game, is Greg. Of course, he was the star of the playoffs for Utah in their run before he lost 4-2 to Chicago in the championship last year. Signed a big contract, came into camp out of shape. Karl Malone jumped all over him. Then, of course, in the first game, which we were televising on TNT with Utah and L.A., Shaquille O'Neal went up to him and slapped him. It's not been a good year for Greg. He had a stress fracture in his fibula, too.
I tell you what, at 7'2", when you have nobody in front of you, you go for a two-hand dunk, that's supposed to go down. I don't care about anything else. That is ridiculous for a guy 7'2" to miss that type of dunk.
12-point Jazz lead. Houston hanging around, and this has been a Jazz quarter with 4:25 to go, but Houston hanging just close enough so that a couple of buckets can get him down inside that 10-point mark. Isley left alone for the jumper, though. He beat Malone. Malone once again said, where's the help inside?
And I tell you what a great pick by Karl Malone. Down low to free up Isley. He came up wide open.
Eddie Johnson from Elijah Wong. Not tonight. Malone with a rebound in front of Charles Barkley, who had just come into the game. Barkley, Ellie, Maloney, Elijah Wan, and Eddie Johnson on the court right now for the Houston Rockets. Isley, nice dish to Brian Russell. Barkley said, no, Eddie, you get paid for shooting. I need the board. Charles Barkley, by the way, would have been fourth in rebounding this year if he'd have played 70 games or had 700 rebounds, but he played 68 games and had only 794. But he would have been fourth had he qualified statistically.
Charles Barkley doing a great job of letting the referee know that it was an illegal defense just by holding the ball a little bit longer. Got Greg Ostertag in the illegal position.
That's the second, therefore, the technical will be shot by Eddie Johnson, and then Houston gets it sideline out of bounds as they trail now by 13, 3:25 to go in the quarter. I got a great job for Charles if he quits playing active basketball, officiating.
Wouldn't that be ironic? It would serve him right.
Kind of a purgatory of his
yeah,
own.
Exactly.
Charles, up and under. Elijah Wan with an offensive board. Ostertag got it out of his hands and then cleared it to Hornacek. Hakeem is not the dream tonight. He's really struggling. Barkley against Malone. That's a fadeaway. Not only did he fade away, he faded out of the picture when Barkley gave him a little tap there.
Very difficult to defend that shot as he's gone to that quite a bit in this half. Showing us different looks, giving Barkley a real hard time down low, and it's so hard, Bob, because when you get the body pressure on you, there's nothing you can do but fall away with the man and try to slap at it.
Tomorrow at 6:30, Rob Morrow stars in the TNT original, The Day Lincoln Was Shot. Karl Malone's numbers, 13-8. I gave it the Siskel and Ebert. They didn't give it the thumbs up, but I'm sure they would have if we were to ask him. Really good movie, hope you'll dial into on TNT. I enjoyed Charles Barkley's comments. He's talking about Malone and Stockton. He says, no question, they're future Hall of Famers. He's John Stockton's the greatest point guard ever, and Karl Malone is one of the greatest power forwards.
And he's not supposed to give it up like that.
3 minutes to go in the period. 68-53, Jazz by 15. Led by five at the half. Elijah Wan got inside of Ostertag for the short baseline jumper. Stockton getting a lot of rest this period. And as Isley, as he's done all year long, holds the court very well.
See the timing on their pick and roll, how they start down low and then bring it up. really sets the tone for the spacing. This team is very, very smart and executes well. That was a picture-perfect pick and roll. Isley 1-4 with Karl Malone.
Good call, Reggie. That was exactly well executed, almost Houston-like in the penetration and the kick out. And the Bryon Russell triple.
And a nice kick out, drive and kick basketball. That's what we love to see.
For sports news and scores around the clock, ask for CNN Sports Illustrated.
With formidable strength, a distinctly individual style, and the strongest V8 in its class, this is the most powerful Sierra in GMC's history. Sierra gives you the style to stand apart from the herd. And the power to pull it. Sierra by GMC, putting you comfortably in command.
Now, the way you view weather will change forever. Introducing News 5's Live Power Doppler. Live Power Doppler is 1,000 times more powerful than the average radar.
Now we have the power to zoom in on a storm with pinpoint accuracy.
This radar's enormous power allows us to give you the earliest possible warning before severe weather strikes.
The power of pinpoint accuracy. The power of earlier warning. Live Power Doppler, only on News 5.
25 years in the making, this is a big one. A Latham Ford Silver Anniversary Tag Sale. As the only Kansas City dealer in Ford's top 100 dealers, a Latham Ford's putting 25 years of buying power behind this sale. You'll save thousands on hundreds of new cars, trucks, and vans during the Silver Anniversary Tag Sale. Only from Kansas City's number one Ford dealer, a Latham Ford. Just east of I-35 on Santa Fe, next to a Latham Lincoln Mercury.
Things are starting to happen here at the Delta Center. The Jazz enjoying a 16-point lead, and I'm with Bobby Sloan. Bobby, did Jerry rehearse his pregame speech because these guys came out inspired?
Well, I don't know that he rehearsed it in front of me, but I think he has done this many times before. We've been at this for 33 years, and every year we say, it can't get better than this, but here we are again, and it is better than this.
You have the perfect seat by design, you said. Why did you end up in this section?
Well, I have four seats right behind the bench where Jerry is, but I just watched him. And so I said, I need to go see somewhere where I can see the game. So I bought these two tickets, and now I can see the whole game here.
Very good. You're seeing a great one tonight. Bob, Reggie?
Thank you, Dee. She could also say, honey, loaf of bread, milk, cottage cheese on your way home.
Bring me a paper.
Minute 58 to go in the period, 71-57 Jazz. Look at the Houston defense turning up a notch. Elijah Wan comes away with the ball. Barkley behind the back to Bryon Russell. Oh, the fans love that mistake.
Well, we probably saw the adjustment that Houston's going to make on the pick and roll.
Malone is fouled. Excellent defense starting the break for Houston. Charles had it on the run, tried to go behind his back. Didn't see Bryon Russell. Russell got it, and it turns into a Malone free throw.
Great defense on one end. Charles trying to find his handles. Charles. Good idea. It was going right for him, but then Bryon Russell making a very nice defensive play.
How much, as Akeem picked up his fourth personal, Drexler also with four, how much is Houston struggling? Well, how about this? They have more turnovers than baskets. Five turnovers, four hoops this quarter. Elijah wants 3 of 5. The rest of Houston, only 1 of 9 in the period. It's a reversal. I've said it 2 or 3 times, but it's amazing how much this game has been a mirror in reverse of game number one.
No question. It really did start with the effort in the beginning of the game. The Jazz coming out setting the tone. Utah Jazz going into that pick and roll quite a bit. Houston was playing it straight up. Now it looks like they're going to be double teaming that pick and roll, trying to get the ball out of the point guard's hands into some scramble offense.
The extra effort balls are going to Utah also. They get the offensive rebound off the Malone miss. Leading by 15. 1:23 to go in the third period. 6 on the shot clock. Malone ball fake, drive and shoot. at 6'9", 260 pounds like a guard, Reggie.
But they execute so well. They did a great job in double teaming, and then they go to the second and third option, and that being Karl Malone shooting from the perimeter.
Malone to the hoop, didn't get a call, missed it. Malone got the rebound. Maloney to the hoop. Malone with the rebound. His ninth. Karl. Uh-oh, look out.
See Karl get into his rhythm on that. A one bounce, turn, get into his fuego, and then fall back.
20 in the game, 11 in the quarter for Malone. Kevin Willis trying to shoot it over the 7-2 Ostertag. The turnover into the hands of Brian Russell. He's fouled at half court with 38 seconds to go in the third period. Utah, throughout the season with their 62 wins, the third quarter, much like the Chicago Bulls, was their quarter all year long.
And that's because of their veteran team. They know how important that is, and they go in at halftime a lot of times, Bob, and veteran, smart veteran teams make adjustments at halftime and come out, and because of their abilities, they get right into it and handle it like the pros they are.
Russell with the free throw, as I said, 38 seconds in the period. We're going to get Shandon Anderson on the floor for Jeff Hornacek in this final 38 seconds. Utah has scored 30 points in this period. They had 14 in the period in this third quarter in game number one. Elijah wants Drexler on the bench there. Bullard in the middle between them. Both Drexler and Elijah Wan carrying four personal fouls. Shot of Barkley talking.
Utah really doing the things that they have to do tonight, Bob, and that is the transition defense has been great, and then their effort offensively has been superb.
21-point Utah lead.
And of course, especially defensively, just as you saw, getting their hands on a lot of balls, and then that causing opportunities on the offensive end. Just tremendous effort by the Utah Jazz.
Well, Jerry Sloan never minces words. He certainly minced none after game number one. He said, Houston threw us down, talked to us, stepped over us, intimidated us.
And then stood over us and said, what you gonna do about it?
Exactly. And you said, pretty good psychology.
Very good psychology.
With this kind of team, because if you go right to their pride, I can't imagine, and neither could Jerry, that they would respond.
But that's how Jerry Sloan deals with his teams. That's why he's so effective with the stability of this team and the personality of this team. He is one of the straight talkers of the league and just tells it flat like it is. We got worked in game one. That's exactly what he told them. If we can't get into it and stroke people, we're not going to win.
Points off turnovers in this game. Utah has outscored Houston 21-6. 16 seconds in the period. Barkley no doubt will take the final shot. That's where my money is. Back again, Antoine Carr. Shot clock to 5. Up and under, stripped again, but the foul is called, and Charles will go to the line. See if his free throw practice pays off better than it did his first trip to the line.
Boy, there's a very helpless feeling when you got a guy like Karl Malone backing you down slowly, waiting. You know he's going to shoot it, or he's waiting for the defense to come. Something definitely going to happen. What a tough situation.
Karl on the bench the final minute or so of this is Barkley. He could back Antoine Carr down a little bit better than he can Karl Malone.
So I'm telling you, both those guys.
That's a load.
Hey, both those guys got a lot of junk in the trunk. I'm telling you, it's difficult. Barkley backing down Big Dog, that's something else.
Junk in the trunk. You never cease to entertain me. Barkley got his own miss and put back with 1 second left in the period. He's got his junk in the trunk, too. 19-point lead for Utah at this quarter. They led by 5 at the half, so they outscored Houston by 14 points in the third period. 79 points for the Jazz in this ballgame with 12 to go.
Only one full-size pickup delivers the strong, even release of power that comes from having a flat torque curve. Sierra by GMC. Sierra gives you the style to stand apart from the herd and the smooth, steady power it takes to leave it behind. Sierra by GMC, putting you comfortably in command.
In the Northwest, it rains 200 days a year. In the Sun Belt, the sun never stops. In the Heartland, weather is extreme. Your home has its own climate, and now it has its own paint. New Dutch Boy Climate Guard. Five different exterior paints formulated to withstand the specific weather conditions in the five different regions of the country, guaranteed for 20 years. So wherever your home is, give it the special protection it needs. Give it the lasting look of new Dutch Boy Climate Guard paints.
Check out that game last night. What a finish.
Yeah.
Let's keep it light. Want to go for five?
Sure. Would that be minutes or miles?
Wow. Hey, you want to slow it up?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm having a little problem here.
Barry, we've gone like 50 yards.
Yeah, it's these shoes, man. I mean, this was cool, man. I'm glad we did this, but there's something I gotta do. It's the shoes or something.
Barry, come on, man.
I got things to deal with. I gotta get out of here, man.
So it's called the AT&T $2 million shootout, huh?
Five shots, $2 million.
$2 million.
It's the NBA Finals.
$2 million.
Could be me.
Just call 1-888-6-FINALS and you can win a trip to the NBA Finals and a shot at $2 million or thousands of other prizes. So call now.
Hey, Lenny, know what you could do with $2 million? You can move that basket higher and to the right.
Just call 1-888-6-FINALS now.
It's a hard play to defend because of the players. No, we're not talking about, yeah, if Larry Limbo and Jesse James were running the pick and roll, it wouldn't be a big deal. But when you got the greatest point guard ever and a great, great power forward, it's not the same.
You're always talking about angles and spacing offensively. Let it go, guys. Right here, Karl Malone comes in and sets a nice pick on Maloney. Stop it, let it go. And then if you don't step out, John Stockton, stop right there. Draws the defense. Look at this defense. And then Stockton looking for the open guy, Foster, finding a way to make it happen, and then the extra pass down low. I love it.
I think you like that.
I love that kind of basketball.
Pick and roll, look at this. 10 times tonight, 18 points. Houston had that pick and roll defensed in game number one. By the way, who did Larry Limbo and Jesse James play for? Carr, mid-range jumper, not that time. Barkley with the board. He has five rebounds tonight, does Charles. Jazz by 19. Houston has 11 minutes, 40 seconds to make a comeback.
If you really want to know, is the Washington Generals in the Globetrotters.
Yeah. I saw you doing a Globetrotters game not too long ago.
I had a lot of fun.
They're still fun.
I knew everything they were going to do and still had a great time.
That's another post-NBA job for Charles. He'd punch me if he heard me say it. You have no respect for my game. Seven on the shot clock. Turnaround Eddie Johnson. Ostertag with a rebound. In the third period, Houston was only 5 of 16, 31%. Elijah Wan was 3 of 5, but the rest of the Houston Rockets were 2 of 11 in that third period. That's why the 20-point lead for Utah. Isley couldn't get the lay-in to fall. Jazz by 19. Houston's got a run in them. If they have a run in them, they could cut this thing down to around 10 points and we still have a game. Drexler back in with his four. How about that move? But it didn't fall. Not tonight. Not tonight for Houston.
Didn't do anything but cause another fast break opportunity for Utah. And of course, Bob, they capitalized. They're one of the best running teams in the league. People don't give them enough credit. They average over 100 points a game, and most of it because they have guys on the first team and the second team that can get up and down the floor.
Brian Russell with three threes tonight, and now he's defending Clyde. Willis hosted against Ostertag, and the foul is called by Ken Maurer. Here's Brian Russell's three. Brian only shot 34% from beyond the arc since they moved it out this year. He was better last year.
He's always talking about give me some air time. I told him before the game, you got to hit a shot to get a replay over here.
You're cold. Brian Russell, fifth season, Long Beach State, 28 years old. 9 points, four boards he averaged this year. A less than average year for Brian Russell.
A lot of people wondering, how did Clyde Drexler know that Kevin Willis was right behind him? The reason is because he knows the veteran player is going to follow and step into the slots when the defense goes to double. Tremendous basketball knowledge by these two guys. Just a great play.
Jazz by 22. Kevin Willis
has been relatively quiet tonight. Kevin has 8 points in the game, now nine. I say relatively quiet, 11 boards. But he's only 3-for-8 from the floor. Got them both that time, made it a 20-point Jazz lead with 10:21 to go. Looks like this series, is, unless a real shock happens, is going to go to Houston for a game on Wednesday. These teams will have Sunday, Monday, Tuesday off, 3 days off between before they play in Houston for game three. Undoubtedly go there tied at one game apiece. Houston deflected that pass. Isley had to put up the prayer. Banked it home. It's that kind of night for the Jazz.
Even Charles Barkley had to smile after that shot.
22-point Utah lead. Willis, you could see his lack of confidence. He hesitated before that shot. All caused by the intense defense.
Nowhere near the same basketball looks the Rockets are getting tonight because the Jazz defense has been swarming.
In the four regular season games, that foul's going to be on Willis. In the four regular season games, which Utah swept, three of them were close, and in fact, Houston had led in the fourth quarter. There was one blowout in that series. This may be the second blowout of the year.
Today's forecast calls for record-breaking temperatures throughout the metropolitan area.
Take the sport utility concept to a higher level. Enter the new Durango. Its best-in-class power, cargo space, and seating for up to 8 raise the bar considerably, as do its strongest-in-class frame and its stable, longer, wider stance. Dodge Durango, a higher form of sport utility, from top to bottom. Durango, new ground for the new Dodge.
Reminder to tune into NBC tomorrow at noon for Showtime, followed by a triple header. Knicks Heat at 12:30, game two. Blazers Lakers at 3, game two. Nets Bulls at 5:30, game two. Then, tomorrow night, I guess it's a quadruple header if you count both of us, and I always do count both of us. Pre-game show at 8:30 on TNT Eastern Time, followed by the Wolves Sonics, game two. Inside the NBA at 11:30 Eastern tomorrow night. So four playoff games available for you on television tomorrow, Sunday. Guess a lot of lawns will go unmown. You guys are scoring by half yards. You take a look at the difference in this. 20 points for Houston in this second period.
And a lot of that has a lot to do with the defense by the Utah Jazz. Houston shooting only 33% for this game. In game one, they shot a 46.5 clip for the game. The defense has been enormous.
Remember where Jerry Sloan got that little mark there on the left cheek? I think maybe he was...
Probably didn't bring that paper home that his wife was talking about.
When Jerry Sloan was playing at Chicago, before he coached you at Chicago, Jerry Sloan was as marked up as any player I've ever seen.
I tell you what, he came in as a coach. He was Jerry Sloan, ex-player coach in that first year, but you could see so much of the potential. Now he's Jerry Sloan, big time, one of the best coaches in the league.
Probably, I think, will win the NBA Coach of the Year. I don't know that. There's several good candidates, obviously. Eddie Johnson.
Well, he's got my vote mainly because he's gone so unrecognized for so long, and this team has done nothing but win 50 games and go to the playoffs 15 years in a row.
Yeah, simply 15 years in a row. Think of that. There's Bobby with an E.
Said she moved away from the bench so she could quit looking at her husband and watch the game.
8:40 to go in the ballgame. 85-65, Jazz by 20. Houston not really showing signs of making a comeback. Six on the shot clock for Heisley and the Jazz.
Good
Price, great steal. But uh-oh.
He's got time.
He's going to pull up for the three.
And yes. Why not?
He saw the big dog headed underneath the basket. And he, Brent Price, of course, Mark's brother. I'm sure everybody knows that. Brent Price had 4 3-pointers in game number one. That was Brent's first NBA playoff game ever. He was always injured in another opportunity.
And that particular shot, it's only a bad shot if it doesn't go in.
You know,
you gotta take the heat when it doesn't go in.
You know what that reminded me of? 77 NCAAs watching practice of the UNLV running Rebs with one sudden Sam Smith.
Oh, yeah.
And Reg, you fellas practiced that at practice, pull-up threes.
You. No question. Tark said, hey, whenever you feel it, let it fly. Sam Smith, Tony Smith, those guys can really feel it.
Yeah.
But
and the,
they went cold on us in that game.
Yes, they did. In the big game. Well, you live how many times you're hurt.
I know.
Live by life. 85-68, Rockets.